Morning, YouTubers, subscribers, and everybody. So this video today is talking about never let somebody lay their hands on top of your head, on your head, that is. So because it's a transference of the spirits, unless it's somebody you trust and it's an elder, somebody you know is transferring blessings, but how you know? So just don't let anybody lay their hands on top of your head, because that's transferring the spirits into you, his spirit. So you don't know what he did behind the scenes out there, and or she did. Now all of a sudden he's coming to lay hands on your head. Now all those demons, because now when you lay somebody your hands on top of something, you're connecting to something, because the head is more like a portal and entry to anybody. Okay, so more like tattoos or portals. Now the head is a normal portal that's just there, it's open. So if somebody lay their hands on your head, you're opening up to whatever they can transfer into you. So if it's demons that are in that person, them demons can jump into you and get into you anytime they want. So you don't want anybody to try to put their hands on your head, even if they're talking about they're praying for you, they have good intentions, but you don't know what else is you know, taking a ride on that person's body, and they'll jump onto you. Okay, so when somebody's hand is on top of your head, you're open up, because you're connecting, you're connected to that person. It's like when you're sleeping with somebody, so you're connected to the same thing. So when somebody put their hands on top of your head, you are connected to that person, and that the spirits of that person transfer into you. Okay, not the other way around, because now the other way around is they leave you through your feet and through your hands. So if any spirit gotta leave you, it goes to your feet and your hands. Okay, so that's why they if they want to offload something onto somebody else, they put their hands. Okay, they could put their feet on top of your head, but I mean, that looks crazy. So the hands do exactly the same thing like the feet is doing. So they offload, it's an exit. Okay, so the entrance is the head, the exit is the feet and the hands. Okay, so let's look at some verses on the scripture that talk about this. See, remember Exodus, Leviticus, we'll pull up a few of them. There's Numbers as well, but I'm just going to pull up a few of them that show you when this laying of the hands was used. Okay, just to show it's a transference of spirit. It can be good spirit or bad spirit. Okay, so bear that in mind. So in Exodus, it says, "Then you shall bring the bull before the tent of meeting, and Aaron and his sons shall lay their hands on the head of the bull." Okay, so all of this, head of the bull, head of the burnt offering, head of the sin offering, as you can see all over there, I bolded it for you so you can identify the points, the main key lines that you want to focus on. So when you lay your hands on top of something, you're transferring yourself. So in this case here, these children of Israel were transferring their sins to the bull. So it's like you're offloading your sins on the head of the bull, on the bulls, through the head. Okay, so they're putting their hands on top of the bull, as you can see all over there, or the sin offering, whatever they're bringing, goat or whatever they're bringing as a sin offering. So they have to confess their sins and even let them sins out, you know, speak it out. So, and then their hand is connected to the bull. Okay, so you offloading whatever you got, whatever sins you got, offloading them onto the bull or onto whatever you're offloading it to. So don't let somebody else offload their sins on you. You don't know what they got. They might get into you. And, you know, don't, unless it's somebody blessing you, you know that this person here is really, you know, really blessing you, then. But if it's, you know, somebody say, "Hey, can I pray for you?" and then all of a sudden, you know, no, you don't, you want to be careful about that, because that is transferring of spirits. Okay, now here's another situation in the Bible again where it's the good transference. Okay, it's a good spirit transfer. So you want Jacob or to have Israel or Jacob to have his hands on top of your head, because he's blessing you, right? So that's permissible, because it's a blessing, like he did with his two sons, Ephraim and Manasseh. Okay, so he was blessing them, putting his hands on their head. Okay, so, you know, that's a blessing part. So here's another part, you know. Now this process, I'm just showing you some verses in the scripture that show it's a transference of spirits, okay? It's not just laying a hand, say, "Buddy, what you doing?" There's a whole lot of things involved behind the scenes. So that's what this video, I'm trying to show you through this video, that Transfer of hands is not an innocent gesture like shaking hands. No, it is a transfer of spirit. So you want to look at it with a fine-tooth comb. Be careful who puts their hand on your head. Okay, so here, let's look at this. And thou shalt bring the Levites before the Lord, and children of Israel put their hands upon the Levites. Okay, this is Numbers. I forgot to put in. You can Google it and find. So put their hands upon the Levites. That's step number one. And then Aaron shall offer those Levites as the sacrifice. So those Levites are full of sin now, because the children of Israel put their hands on top of the Levites, on their hands, on the Levites. Okay, so that means they're offloading their sins on the Levites' head. Okay, now you understand. Thereafter, when the Levites are walking now with all the sins of the children of Israel, then Aaron has to offer them Levites as a sin offering, like as an offering for the children of Israel. Okay, like, but now, because, you know, we don't want to kill all the Levites, then the Levites shall go and find a bull, or some, you know, bullock is a bull, and transfer and offload all of those sins that are in them into, now that's 12. So it goes chronologically like that. Put their hands upon the Levites, offer the Levites as the sin offering, and then the Levites go and find a bull to offload into that bull, and then you take that bull and burn it. Okay, so you're burning all them sins away from everybody. Okay, so that's how it happened in the Bible. So that shows laying hands on somebody's head is a transfer of sin. Okay, now you understand. So even be careful, even if it's not just the head, somebody on your shoulder can put your hands on your shoulder. So you don't really know what other entry, especially people who got tattoos. Those tattoos are entry portals. But now they like a tattoo of a snake. So a snake spirit can enter and leave anytime as they please. Okay. So they are fully inviting them spirit, the snake spirit, to come in and out. Okay, spirit of a lion, that's exactly the same thing. They're inviting in and out as they wish, all those spirit, the lion spirit in there. So whatever tattoo a person has, that's the spirit that they're summoning full-time. And it's a portal, full-time portal they're creating. So be careful if you want to do some tattoos there. So you want to, you know, you're creating a portal when you're making a tattoo. So, but now the head is the full-time in there. So you know. So I hope you understand. So next time if somebody talk about they want to pray for you, you want to lay hands on your head, you want to first, you know, do Google them. Make sure you know that person, okay? You know that person very well, especially Gabby's probably your relative, somebody you trust really good. They'll be blessing. They have blessing themselves, okay? Not somebody you don't even know what they're doing out there. So, you know, just try and understand that. That's what I'm trying to show you here through this video. Bye.